Hello everyone, thanks for joining and I'm super excited to have you all here and excited about all the amazing conversations that we are going to have today with the passionate educators of iGebra.ai. Hello, how are
Hi.
You all
Hi.
doing?
Hi, hi Kirtna, hello everyone.
Hi everyone.
Hi everyone.
Yeah. So would you like to tell me what exactly is Math++ and what we do at iGebra.ai? Palak, let's start with you.
Okay, so like at iGebra.ai, we are not talking about general maths. Actually, we are talking about Math++. So I would like to explain what Math++ plus exactly is. So Math++ plus means Math plus Data plus AI thinking, where AI stands for Artificial Intelligence, or we can say Art and Intelligence. So we are just making the kids not math as a burden. We want kids to just learn the basics things and find math as an interesting subject. So that is our basic values that we follow in iGebra.
Great. So why do you read? So why it is important, really important for kids to learn math from a young age, and how do you demonstrate it and connect it to the real world examples? Anyone would like to answer that?
Okay, can I answer?
Yes, yes. Go ahead.
I just want to share some slides. Is that okay?
Yes, definitely.
Okay, fine. Yeah. Let me share. So all of you, can you see my screen?
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
Okay. So let me start this with a question. What are the main goals of mathematics education? I think for a while. I know all of you know that. But yeah, done. Tell me the answers. Let's start with it.
Okay.
Yeah, please go. Yeah. Gargi, please.
So I think like maths is the main essence that is required in day-to-day life. And it's more like, you know, mathematics education is not about achieving something, but it's like, I'm just like able to cope up with my daily things. Like it is required everywhere. Like, I think it's required everywhere, from kids to adults, like from buying groceries to making, cooking something in any special ingredients. So everywhere maths is required, according to me. So
excellent.
that is like, you know, that should be known to everyone, and everyone should be like clear about all the things, how to do that. Yeah.
Okay.
That's what I think.
Yes. Anyone else can add something to the plate? Yes.
Yes, math is actually mother of science. So without math, there is nothing. So that's why kids are learning from the young age.
Yeah, definitely. I agree with you as well. Okay, so any other answers before I move on? I just need a few other answers. That's it.
I'll say math is an integral part of life. So whatever we do, math is everywhere, related to our growth or our day-to-day activity. Math is everywhere.
Definitely. Yes, Karuna, you were saying something. Yeah.
Yes, so I think that math is useful in any stream that we want to move ahead with, be it data science, be it artificial intelligence, be it fashion designing, or anything else. I think math is really important, and it plays an integral part, and also a significant part, I think.
I completely agree. Yeah. So what if I say that we have only one main goal of education? Particularly mathematics education. Do you agree? That is mathematization of the learner's thought process. And whatever you answered, we can relate that to this word. Everything will come under this word. Okay, now let's see what mathematization means. Actually, what happens? Mathematization means reduction to mathematical form. Just try to understand. If you have a daily life problem, okay, then what we do, we first simplify the problem. Okay, I will tell you with one example. For example, daily life problem is, if I am having zero savings, okay, that's my problem. So now let's define it. Zero saving means I am having zero balance in my saving account. Okay, now what we will do, we will try to solve this. It's a real life problem. Now what I will do, with the help of mathematization, means we will reduce it to mathematical form. I am having zero account balance. That means, okay, let me take you help of few annotations. Okay, zero account balance, okay, or savings, particularly savings account balance means how we define it. Okay, whatever I earn, okay, and whatever I spend, it's equal. Is that okay?
Yeah.
So I want balance in my savings account means what? It should be earning minus spending should be greater than zero. Is that okay?
Yeah.
That means it's a linear inequality again. Earning should be greater than saving, or else earning should be greater than spending, or else spending should be less than earning. So I got a solution. Is that okay? So
yeah.
I got the solution. Now I will apply this, interpret the solution in the daily life problem. Okay. And I will see whether it is solving my purpose or not. I am validating the thing. Okay. So that's the main important role. And see how mathematization helps. Mathematization is the process. Means where you transform the daily life problem, whether it's buying groceries or anything, building or constructions or civil engineering or computer science, anything. We just define the problem in terms of mathematics. So don't you think mathematization is the important goal of mathematics?
Indeed, what? It is.
Yeah, yeah. So what happens? This takes me to the next slide. I'm not telling this. Actually, this was coined by a great computer scientist. I don't know why it got stuck. Yeah, David Wheeler. So he says in his words, it is more useful to know how to mathematize than to know a lot of mathematics. Okay. Mm-hmm. He was a pioneer in computer science and was a professor from UK. So exactly, that's what we do in iZebra. We inspire curiosity and freedom of thinking in kids with Math++. All of you know about Math++, right? So Math++ means math plus data plus AI thinking. And by the time you know that how maths is important. So what we do in iZebra and how we enhance this mathematization process is we have interactive math and application-based math. Okay, let me tell you each and everything how we do that is in interactive math. We have a small group because we are confined to 3 to 4 students in a class, right? So the interaction is more. And we make the advanced curriculum in a simplified way. We present them in a simplified manner so that it doesn't hamper their understanding process. And that too, we have videos and sometimes some softwares we are using, for example, GeoGebra or something, so that we can give them visualization which may help in retaining the attention of the child. And we have homework support as well. For example, here in homework, we don't give simple homeworks. We give homeworks related to their daily life so that they feel connected to math, not as an alien subject, but as something to talk about, something to speak about. And we have supplementary classes as well. Those who don't understand homework, okay, we can have supplementary classes that is one-to-one particularly, and we can clear their doubts, whatever they have. Okay, that too, when you have, when I'm talking about application-based, and let me make it clear, interactive math and application math are not two separate entities. Our main focus is to merge them. Okay, so we apply that mathematical thinking in coding math art by the help of Scala. Similarly, apply mathematical thinking in coding IPy games by the help of Scala. We use Python for data science and Python for machine learning and AI. And we use Math++ or math thinking for storytelling with data plus AI. So what I try to say is, see here, we know that math is important and we are not avoiding that. And we are helping to mathematization of the child's thought process. That's fine. But along with that, as a futuristic edutech company, what we are doing, we are keeping in mind the future prospects. Okay. That is how the world is going to be of data and AI after a few years. That's how we are bringing future to the present so that we can achieve our ultimate aim. That is mathematization of child's thought process. Yeah. So anyone is having any feedback?
So that was like wonderful explanation, like how we are compiling things together of maths, data, AI, and how you explained actually like wonderfully, like what exactly we are doing in the iGebra.ai. One more thing I would like to add in this is like Mahesh clearly told that we are doing Scala encoding and then we are doing Python. So we have even segregated Scala for the lower grade and the Python for the higher grades, which actually, you know, encourages them a lot. So we have felt that, and we have seen that in the kids' eyes also, like they actually enjoy what we do in Scala, that is like particular shapes, particular polygons, and the higher syntax for the higher grade. So that actually inspires them a lot. Yeah, that's it for my side.
Okay.
Yeah. So I want to know that people have a belief or thinking that they think it is very difficult for kids to learn coding, design thinking, data thinking. So is it really true? Do they face the, I mean, is it difficult or they cannot do it, something like that?
Yeah, I think Gargi can explain that.
Would you like to answer that?
Yes.
Yeah, of course. So according to my experience, what I have felt being 6 months in this company, so I might have the same doubt in my mind when I just started, like in the initial days, that would kids be able to do the coding in such a earlier age. But I was amazed, I was stunned to see their reactions in the homeworks. So they were like, I'm giving them a code, like I just explained something, and they're grasping it so well that they are making their own shapes. Even that is like beyond our imaginations. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like they are making something, and I am adding that in my module, that I have to keep make the shape in the another class. So it's like that, because like kids are so imaginative that we cannot, I that's inexplicable for me. I cannot explain you like how imaginative they are, and you know, they come up with so many different beautiful shapes that we have to, you know, I am just like, I have to add this thing in my content, and I have to make other kids learn the same thing so that they will come up with something more. It's like that. It's very easy for them because they related with maths, and it's like very simple for them to do.
Yeah. I mean, it's great. We are teaching
to add
kids.
To Gargi's answer, I feel the grown-ups who already know about coding, they might be scared of coding, because kids, it is a new thing to them, and actually they don't have any fear related to coding in them, and that is why I feel it's more easy for kids to learn coding than as compared to grown-ups.
Yes, definitely. And the great thing is, like, we are teaching kids new things, but it's more beautiful that we are learning from them as well. It's like two-way thing.
Exactly.
How wonderful.
Yeah.
So how curious are your kids? I mean, the students. Just tell us a few stories, interesting stories. I know Ishita would have many of them. She is rocking all the classes.
So, yeah, class experiences, like, see, what we do here, we don't just teach, you know. Our main focus is to give that confidence to the kid, right? Because if you make your kid confident enough, he or she can do anything, right? So what happened in our classes, like you said, where with the lower kids, coding might feel like a big thing, right? But it is not, literally. When I teach them coding, they'll be like, okay, ma'am, let's just do one thing. If you're doing this thing, why not we do use that code and let's just see what happens. Like, that's what they actually do. And they're like, okay, if this is not working, let's just do this and that. So they are feeling confident with coding, and they are feeling confident with maths as well, because with the maths, their logical thinking is developing, right? And they're using that logic in coding as well. So that's how the classes goes. They just started it, they don't even feel like, okay, if I'm doing right or wrong. No, they just want to give it a try, and they're like, okay, let's do this and that. And kids were like, 2 hours, like 1.5 hours are so much less for us, just give me 6 hours straight of maths and coding, we can do it. That's how it goes.
That's great. I mean, that's the specialty of Math Plus Plus. We give kids the freedom and the curiosity to explore, and they are free to make mistakes. I mean, it's only then they can learn. It's fantastic. And so, Bindita, yeah, please go ahead.
Yeah, I'm so sorry. I am just so curious to share one of my experiences. So it's like I was taking one like third or fourth grade session, and there, like, we introduce new commands every time in the class, like, you know, set fill color, set pen color, we all know that. So it's like there was one command regarding draw stage black or white, whatever background you want in your screen. So I just introduced that function, that command with the kids. And other day the kid was like, ma'am, can we use set background? And I was like, I'm not sure about that. We can try using that. And it actually worked. And there was their own thing, you know, they didn't Google it, or it was, they actually introduced it themselves and it worked. And I was also amazed, you know, this is the cognitive thinking that, you know, we are, that they are, you know, exploring themselves, and they are doing great jobs. Just like that.
The innovative students of Math++.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Vinita, you have any experience to share with us?
Yeah, I was, when Gargi was telling about that, like, you asked a question that sometimes parents are like, we think that kids can be, it will be very advanced thing for them to understand data thinking and AI thinking and coding and all. But I think we think limited, and it is because we relate this with professional jobs or like that. That's why we think limited about it. But for them, like everyone said, that it's new for them, right? They don't think limited. They it's for them, it's like math or other subject. They just, and because they can see the colors and shapes there, so they are very, very curious and they want to learn. Like in my classes, I want to tell you that, like, they are demanding to design a fish, to design a train, to design a car, like that. And I said, okay, let's do that. Like, and I am also learning, because I never designed a fish. Okay. But I thought, okay, let's do it together. They are giving their suggestions, and I'm applying things. So that's how it is happening. And one more thing, like, they really, really love to correct us. They really love to teach us also, and they enjoy it a lot. So, and I really enjoy this. This is actually like learning for us also. So I really like
it. I mean, by listening to all the experiences, I feel like we are definitely developing data thinking and AI thinking in kids, and we are nurturing it to another next level. I mean, these kids are doing wonders.
Yes.
And I would like to add one more thing, Karuna. Like, I don't think we are just teaching maths, but we are actually making curiosity and confidence an integral part of the kid personality. So if they are going to do math with us and coding with us, I tell this thing to parents also, they are going to excel in every subject and in every area of their life, actually, because they will start, like Mahesh used that term, I really like that, mathematical thinking. So that rational, that brings the logical and rational thinking in one's, thought process. So they are able to use it everywhere in every subject. So that's what we are doing here.
We are doing amazing job, let me tell you all. So tell me something about our storytelling, how it is helping kids to evolve.
I think Palak can answer Palak? That better, because like Palak is the one who helped me out in those sessions.
Palak will be able to.
Okay, so most of the times, like, what happens, especially in the lockdown times, we have seen, like, from last 1 or 2 years, the kids are at home. They are in just home environment, and they are so much comfortable with their home environment that they don't care to express themselves like that. But when it comes to storytelling, and when we encourage kids to speak more by showing some pictures or something like that, so it gives them the confidence to speak in front of people, actually. So that is very much important where the storytelling comes in. And I think that kids are doing really great. Even some pictures, if it comes in front of me, I might not have some kind of thinking like that. And the kids will come with some of their stories, some of their thinking. And it really makes me also think in that way. Okay, this can also be a thing, like what the kids are sharing. So it's really interesting. So it's like not me teaching them learning, and it's like we all are growing together. So it's really a fun environment in the classes.
Great.
I want to share something.
Yes, please.
Yeah, it happened in my class once. We were talking, started the session, and we were just talking, me and student. And he was like, okay, ma'am, do you know why COVID come in our world? like that. And he started talking about nature a lot. And he was like, because we are also not doing very good with the nature. So nature is punishing us and like that. And I was like, okay, how is he saying these things? Because he is only fifth grade kid. Okay. Then I thought, okay, like I already said that we think that they cannot think, but they are learning from everywhere. Like, they are grasping information and everything. So they can tell us a story better, I think. Yeah.
True that. I would again like to share my experience. So I would just share one slide, which I showed in my class. So this was the slide. Actually, this was the picture for which I told my students to create a story. So there were two kids in the session. So I just gave them an example, like it's mentioned here that catch the anaconda. So so I just like gave them a few hints that you can create a story related to anaconda catching that, like that. I didn't like explain much. So one of the kid came up with Big Bang Theory, and he was like, there was a big universe and you know it just exploded. So I'm just telling you the gist. And then it like, you know, divided the universe, the world in few parts, and the red part became the world and the outer part is just the space. So he came with a long story. He wrote that and I just loved that. And one of my kids, so she was watching maybe, I don't know, like something related to Discovery Channel. And she was like, this is an amoeba. This is the pseudopodia. And I was amazed that she knows all this thing in third or fourth grade. And she was like, he's just, you know, trying to catch its prey. So I was like amazed, you know, these kids are so innovative, their cognitive thinking and everything is like, it's so interesting for us also to, we enjoy so much in the sessions.
I think, like they just need exposure and like they rock. Yeah.
Yeah.
I wish that when I was studying, I had such amazing Math Plus Plus courses. I would be the first person to join that.
Yeah, me too.
Amazing.
Okay, it's never too late. We are already running the company and you are part of it, right?
Yeah.
It's been a great journey so far. I mean, I have seen myself growing from day one to today. It's been like around more than 8 months that I've been a part of this company, and there's a huge growth and I see the potential of growing even further. I mean, not only kids, we are not only inspiring kids to grow and do more, it is also us who is doing more and dreaming more now. So that's amazing. And so before we leave today, I just want to remind everyone out there that we are doing about our big picture, why we do, what is that we do. We inspire curiosity and confidence in kids to dream more, learn more, do more and become more. We want them not only to survive, but thrive in future. And this can only happen with Math Plus Plus. Like, we not only teach kids the math, So the syllabus of school syllabus, we just explain them along with the school syllabus, the advanced courses, and not only the course, the material, like how we relate it to the real world and how they can practically use it. And with Math Plus Plus, we teach them coding, data thinking, AI thinking, and storytelling. I think it's a amazing big package, which is really helpful for kids to grow and also ourselves. Like, we are here to make great thing happens to young kids, but it is even beautiful that we are learning along with them. It's not only them who is achieving, it's also us, you know. I mean, that's a beautiful thing. And thank you for the wonderful, passionate educators of AIJupyter.ai, that whatever you people are doing, it's amazing. And today's session is wonderful. I mean, we had great, beautiful insights, and it will definitely enlighten many, many, many people. So yeah, any last few comments?
Please,
Karuna, you beautifully said everything.
Yeah. I mean, it's been in my head for long. I wanted to tell to everyone, but this is the perfect platform we found.
So more than like the teaching process, I also like love how this company works. Like, we are not working as a hierarchy structure, but it's more of a, you know, functional pattern where we all work as a team and everyone is available for every other colleague 24/7, and we don't ever hesitate to ask for any help from our mentors or from our colleagues. So I really love how this company works.
As Shrini sir always says, we all are partners here. And no one is working.
Yeah.
That's correct.
Yeah. Okay. It's been great talking to you all. I had a great time and thank you for your time for joining with us. And yeah. Okay then.
Thanks for the
See you all thank next you, week.
Bye-bye. Thank you, Karuna. Thanks, Karuna.
Bye, everyone. Bye, everyone.